What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to add custom jar files to your Apex server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Creating a Minecraft server might eventually include plugins or mods, which both need a specific configuration to fully work. Most of the time, this is going to come down to using either paper or forged jars, which we have in the panel, but sometimes owners want or need a specific version that we don't have built in. Whether it's needing a specific forge build or if you just want a customized setup, custom server jars are the way to do this, but it's kind of confusing for a first-time user. Let's go over how you can use them on your server. Okay, so like I said, custom jars are used for a specific version for server types. Obtaining these involves you downloading them from their respective websites to get certain files. For example, modded jars are typically going to have a libraries folder that holds important data that you'll end up needing for the server to successfully start. But before we do that, we need to prepare the server. Head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then scroll down to find the game file area, and then click the drop-down menu and search for custom server jar. Once that's found, select it and press change version in the prompt, and then click to create a new world, and then click the I'll restart later option. Once you're done, check to see that the custom jar is used for the file name, and if for some reason it isn't, then you can just rename the file yourself. Now, on your computer, find your desired jar file and rename it to custom. Now that you have the file on hand, click the FTP file access near the top left of the main panel, log in, and then enter the jar directory. Checkmark any files that are already there, and then press delete at the top, and then submit the changes and wait for it to complete, and then you can head back into the same folder. Afterwards, press upload in the top left corner, and on the next page, drag and drop the custom jar file into the upload area. If you're uploading a specific version of Forge or a server mod pack, then you're also going to want to upload the Minecraft server jar and the libraries folder here if they're available. Wait for this to reach 100%, and if you're just uploading a new version of Paper or Forge or the like, then you can use your server name at the top to restart the server. If you're uploading a mod pack, then you're going to have to do a few more things before you do a full restart. In most cases with mod pack files, you're going to have extra files that were downloaded along with the jar. You're going to have to upload these files in the same way that you just did, but you're going to have to zip these files before doing that. Once they've been compressed, you can head back into the FTP file access, log in, and then press upload in the top left. Drag and drop the zip files into upload, and once they're 100% done, head back to the main folder and checkmark the uploaded zipped file. Press unzip in the top right corner, and then submit the changes, and wait for everything to finish, and then you can head back to the main panel and restart the server. If the jar isn't loading after uploading it, first make sure that you've set the file name to custom. If you're having issues, then make sure you didn't miss any extra files during the FTP upload. And if all that fails, then it could just be that there's an underlying issue with the jar file that is causing the issue. If you're unable to join the server, it might be due to another issue other than the actual custom jar. In almost all of the cases, you're going to have to create a new world, or it could be that you're missing mods on your launcher or using the wrong game version. If you check all of these issues, you should have no problem joining, but as a last case scenario, you can try connecting with the direct connection option for better connection to the server. Though most people are going to use the most recent versions of Forge or Paper, there are other options always available, so custom server jars are always going to come in handy. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.